Jumper and Freesky. Good day. A couple weeks ago, I posted a public service announcement on my YouTube community tab, which went out to all my subscribers who have clicked on the notification bell to get notified of all TMac FPV videos and community posts. For those who received it, you became aware of the fact the latest Freesky firmware update, version 2, for ACCST D16 protocol receivers is not compatible with the Jumper T16 multi-protocol module. Also, if you have a non-access protocol FreeSky transmitter and you update it as FreeSky recommends with the new transmitter firmware to make it compatible with their new receiver firmware, your transmitter will no longer bind to any of the non-FreeSky built-in receivers on any of your bind-and-fly quads. Make sure to let me know in the comments below how you feel about FreeSky's latest firmware updates. Today, I'm going to give you solutions to this incompatibility issue by providing you with alternative options other than using FreeSky receivers with version 2 firmware. If this sounds good to you, give it a thumbs up below, hit that notification bell, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing. Stop! The first option as a solution to this issue is simply not to update your FreeSky receiver firmware, your ACCST transmitter firmware, or any FreeSky compatible receiver with the ACC D16 firmware version 2.0.1 or later. FreeSky's reason for updating the ACCST D16 firmware was to fix an issue it was having with uncontrolled servo movements under certain conditions, which could have bad effects with things like fixed wing models. For folks who only fly FPV quads, however, it may not be noticeable at all. FreeSky also took the opportunity to strengthen correction and verification capability, and I'll interpret that as to make it incompatible with non-FreeSky transmitters. So if you're not concerned about uncontrolled servo movements on your FPV quad, maybe there's no need to update your ACCST firmware on your receiver or your non-access protocol transmitter. And if you're fortunate enough to have a Jumper T16 with a multi-protocol module, you're still able to fly your bind-and-fly quads, including whoops, with built-in ACCST compatible receivers without doing the update. If you've already updated your receiver, whether it's a FreeSky or FreeSky compatible one, with version 2.0.1 ACCST firmware or later, you should be able to go back to a previous version of the ACCST firmware. At the time of this video's posting, previous ACCST firmware versions were still on the FreeSky site for download. This is the previous version of the RXSR, previous versions of the XM Plus, and also the R9MM. You might want to download them to your computer for safekeeping while they're still available. A third option is to use non-FreeSky branded receivers with the previous version of the ACCST D16 firmware. I've previously done a video on the Jumper R1 receiver, which you can check out through a link below. In addition to that one, Jumper's come out with their Jumper R1F, which has F-port capability, and I've found at least 11 other ACCST firmware compatible receivers, which you can check out at the links in the video description below. And a fourth option is to use Crossfire. Yes, that means you're going to need a Crossfire module. You can get the Crossfire Lite for about $150, which has a max power output of 2 watts, or you can get the Crossfire Micro module for about $70, with a max power output of 100 milliwatts, which is more than enough for all but extreme long-range flights. Remember, these operate at 900 megahertz instead of 2.4 gigahertz, so inherently they're going to have much better range and penetration through objects than transmitting and receiving at 2.4 gigs. I've done a video on the Crossfire module with the Jumper T16, as well as the Crossfire Nano receiver you can check out through a link in the video description below. Of course, my favorite option is option 5, which doesn't exist yet, a true open source firmware for receivers, which we could call OpenRX. That would solve a lot of these issues, and one can only dream. But who knows? It may come out sometime in the not too distant future. Of course, if you have a Jumper T16 or any transmitter with a multi-protocol module, you can go to multimodule.org and take a look at the various other protocols which are available for your use. Here we see FreeSky D and FreeSky X are supported, as well as FlySky and all of these other ones. If you want more details about a specific protocol on this same site, you can go down to protocol details. And as an example, let's take a look at FreeSky X and the details underneath FreeSky X D16 mode is that frequency tuning is required for this protocol. And due to the changes in the protocol, receivers running ACCST V2 firmware, version 2 firmware, are not supported. Only V1 is supported. So this multi-module.org site is a valuable resource for you when determining which protocol you can be using
with your jumper T16 and which protocol to use for various receivers.
So those are some of the different solutions to the FreeSky firmware issues many pilots are having to deal with today. You do have alternative options. Make sure to share this video with your friends to help them out, and let me know in the comments below what you think of FreeSky's firmware update and how you plan on dealing with it. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.